गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू नारायण लाइव क्लासेस। टुडेज असाइनमेंट फॉर क्लास 10 टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। इन दैट फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन डिफाइन पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस। पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, सपोज ए चार्ज इज मूविंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी, दैट इज एट ए वन पोटेंशियल, एट बी द अदर पोटेंशियल, देन द अमाउंट ऑफ वर्क डन इन मूविंग दैट चार्ज फ्रॉम A to B, that work done which is equal to potential difference. Then the work done in moving a charge unit, negative charge, from one potential to other potential, that work done which is equal to its potential difference between two points. Okay, that is about first question. Next one, write the mathematical expression for potential difference with proof. Mathematical expression for potential difference. Take a conductor of length L. Due to electrical forces, the charge will move from point A to point B. That is, electron is moving from point A to point B. Distance is L. Then what is the work done? Force into distance move. According to our basic knowledge, work done is equal to force into displacement. So work done is equal to, which force is acting? Force into displacement, no? Electrical force is acting, Fp, into length mode is L. So this is the work done. Then work done by the electrical force on charge, unit charge, is work done by charge which is equal to Fp into L by Q. But according to our basic knowledge, that is potential. What is potential? Work done in moving a unit positive charge from one potential to the other potential is nothing but potential difference. So this quantity becomes potential difference or voltage. So in place of this, we can write it as V is equal to W by Q, or that is equal to Fp into L by Q. So this is the expression, mathematical expression for potential difference. Okay, next question, define EMF and write its mathematical expression. Define EMF. EMF means electromotive force. Suppose a unit negative charge is moving from positive terminal to the negative terminal, then what is the work done? That amount of work done is nothing but its EMF of the battery or EMF of the cell. That means in any closed circuit, the charge is moving in a closed circuit from one potential, that is positive terminal, to the negative terminal, one rotation, then that is the work done which is equal to EMF of the cell. If the circuit is open, in that case, the charge moving from positive to negative terminal inside the cell is called its EMF. Okay, that is about EMF. Expression for EMF is equal to work done by unit charge. That is equal to, according to work done, basic knowledge, that is electrical force into distance mode by Q. So this is the expression for EMF. Okay. Next question, fourth question. How does a battery maintain a constant potential difference between its two terminals? That means working of battery. Battery possesses two terminals, that is two electrodes, negative charge and positive charge, that is cathode and anode. Inside electrolyte is present. That electrolyte continuously supplies the free ions. That free ions moves to respective terminals inside the battery. Once the saturation takes place. What is saturation? All the negative charged particles will accumulate on one plate, and all the positive charged particles accumulate at the other plate. What happens? If all the charged particles, negative charges are there, that means negative electric field will be created at this plate. Here also, due to positive, all positive charges, electric field will be created. That due to the electrostatic forces, positive charge and electrolyte is supplying continuously positive ion to the respective terminal. So this positive two charges, that repulsive forces will act in between the two positive charges and two negative charges. That means electrostatic repulsive forces. Until what extent this will happen? If chemical force which is equal to electrostatic force, until then the motion of the ions, free ions will take place. Once the plates are saturated, what happens? The motion of the free ions will stops. Now that battery is ready to use. Now you take the battery and connect it to the external circuit. You have connected that battery to external circuit. Now the current passes from positive terminal to negative terminal. That means one ion deficiency will be there. One ion deficiency. That means one electron will move from low potential to high potential. An electron deficiency on cathode plate and reaches to the other terminal, fuses with the positive ion and neutralizes. Here one negative ion deficiency, here one positive ion deficiency. Now the chemical, that is electrolyte, starts its working and supplies two free ions, that is negative ion to negative plate and positive ion to positive plate. Again the process will going on. Next, that electron will move from negative potential to positive potential, that is low potential to high potential, fuses with the positive ion and neutralizes. One deficiency of negative ion, one deficiency of positive ion on the respective plates. Then electrolyte supplies the free ions. Like this, this will going on throughout the motion of the charged particles. So the potential difference between the terminals of the cell always constant because of electrolyte which is present inside the cell. Okay, that's why the potential difference is constant in the cells because of the electrolyte and due to that chemical forces. Okay, this is about the working of the battery. Okay, hope you understood all. Thank you.